The people of the Emirates are the makers of its culture, the makers of the impossible. They dream big, act fast, and empower each other. This is what shapes a nation's culture. From all over the Emirates and across the globe, they are working together to make it possible.
Music was the third parent to me, the best friend, sometimes the girlfriend maybe.
يوم بوقف اني احاول هني انا فشلت.
اول ما تبدا تطبل تدخل شيء تعرف يوفوريا شيء تدخل في شيء احساس في حياتك ما حسيته فانت مش قاعد تسولف مع اللي عدالك ولا قاعد تطالعه بس كلكم فاهمين بعض ما عندكم مايسترو بس كلكم on the beat 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 فكل هذا قاعد يستوي بس بحركة يدي وبضربة العصا
Music was my getaway. Growing up in a somewhat broken household, every time there was some sort of negativity in the house, music was my go-to. Yes, I scream out Dubai a lot, and Dubai is what gave me, I would say, opportunity when it comes to being on a global stage, but Sharjah is the story. Back in the day, you know, the parents that came in from Lebanon and Iraq and Palestine and people who were fleeing from bad situations kind of gathered up in one area in Sharjah. So there was a struggle, but I wouldn't say it was a victimized struggle. If anything, Sharjah taught me to be the survivor and not take the kind of victim role. So yeah, Sharjah is home. It's for me, it was a beautiful upbringing and I wouldn't have it any other way. We're not a country where the blueprint of entertainment was built on drugs and alcohol. With all due respect, like in the Emirates, the entertainment industry was birthed from house parties, from groups, from gatherings, you know, from friends getting together in a villa. And, you know, maybe you have memories of your parents going to like a small restaurant. So that emotion always produces rhythmic music, music that's nostalgic, that makes you feel. What is the most popular music that is like that? It is R&B, it is soul, it is jazz, it is hip hop.
أقدر أقول يوم انولدت هاي كانت لحظة عظيمة حقايق الدنيا الجميلة. كان في عندنا منتديات يصير فيها تحديات يصير فيها مثلا هذا يسب هذا وهذا يسب هذا وهذا عنده جمهور وجمهور هذا يعزز حق هذا It was for fun بديت هيدفون جيمينج ما في مايكروفون ما في ستوديو ما في سيت اب برنامج داسري البرنامج اللي تنزله ببلاش هذا كل حد بدا فيه كلمت بيجي قلت له we need to produce music مقنع فيه المجتمع في الامارات انه ترى الراب العربي is not just for fun
سرت اليابان على اساس ان اسوي الانترنشيب فتميت هناك تقريبا 3 شهور قابلت واحد ياباني اسمه بالياباني يوترو، قال لي شو رايك تجرب شيء جديد او اعلمك شيء جديد عن اليابان وانت تعلمني شيء ما كنت اعرفه عن الامارات.
As an entertainer, it is probably the hardest, the longest, the most brutal and most emotional path you will ever take.
الناس والهيب هوب في المنطقة، انت تغني راب، انت تشمكي. شو يعني تشمكي؟ بين قوسين انسان غير صالح، انسان زبالة. المجتمع كان بادي يتقبل الراب، ولكن صار في حادثة، شخص طلع وسوى فيديو وعساس انه هو قاعد يضرب واحد والراب وانا الاجرام وانا مدري شو، فصار في داونفول للراب، بس قام يرجع شوي شوي. بس at the end of the day هو الفن شوي اجرسيف. And when I say f**k in my music I don't mean f**k يعني، بس it's like insisting يعني انه.
It's always been a dream of mine to fly the Emirates and the Lebanese flag in Tomorrowland. And Tomorrowland, in my world, is the ultimate. It is the holy grail for DJs. In 2017, I was approached. But I was approached through industry politics. And I had to make one of the biggest decisions of my life. I took a stand for doing what is right and not giving up part of my integrity to be on that stage. That was the boldest moment for me.
طبلاتنا وايد مزعجة، فما كان الشيء سهل ان نحصل مكان نقدر نتدرب فيه. وحتى اذا تدربنا في الشارع ان اكثر عن مرة الشرطية ووقفتنا، لأن حتى في ناس في العماير مرات يوصل لها الصوت وتنزعج.
In 2018, everything lined up, the stars lined up, and I got a call to be on that stage. I didn't think twice. I took it, and I took it with a responsibility to go out there, not just as Dany Neville, the DJ, to go out there and show the world that talent could be exported from the Emirates. Tomorrowland was a big stage for me, and I took it, and I took it for the right reasons, and I'm proud I did. And we flew the flag, and I flew both flags, and it was a proud moment.
I'm level up, level up. عطني البني يا بيمر بدون ماي. It sounds better with autotune. عطني البني يا بيمر. كيف؟ الأوتوتون هذا أنت تغني وتحطه يتفاعل مع صوتك، يخلي صوتك حلو. بس في طريقة إنك تغني في الأوتوتون، بس الميلوديز. تعرف يوم when you rap تحط أوتوتون كيف يطلع؟ يطلع أوتوتون شي يسوي، يقول أنت شو قاعد تسوي؟ لم أخلق لهذا. أنا 24 ساعة مع 9 أشخاص موجودين عندي في الاستوديو، أطلعهم هم هذول في الميوزك فيديو، نطلع على طبيعتنا ونطلع بشكل يتقبل يعني. فأنا ما أتخيل يعني إنه ولا أبي إني أنا أطلع في ميوزك فيديو أربعة قاعدين يهزون جنبي. في أشياء كثيرة تساعدك to produce. مثلا you want samples. Hip hop is a sample based art. فطلع samples. Nowadays you sign up to Splice and you have 1 million samples to work with. خليفة ما يقصر، خليفة is my brain. هي تقريبا لما انا اكل هو يفكر عني. حتى مع كل هذه المعدات اللي حولك والامكانيات, if you don't have the ear to do it, ما اذا سمعك مو تمام ما راح تطلع معك اغنيه تمام.
We live in a world where the label has become totally obsolete. And if anybody says otherwise, they don't know what they're talking about. The way the world works now, you can develop all these relationships. Have a nice team around you, have a good manager, maybe a good PR, and you can do it on your own. But what you do need is money. And that's what the label used to bring to the table.
شباب ترى كل واحد عنده شغل ونفس ما قلت لك, we have other jobs اللي ندخل منها income. طبعا ما عندي ليبل يدفع لي مليون درهم عشان يسوي لي ميوزك فيديو فلوس.
Because of where we are in the world, there's so many cultures and musical flavors and stories and backgrounds that transit into the Emirates. They might come and transit and leave, but we take some of it and we keep it here and we put it in our music and we put it in our production.
هل cultural exchange والتبادل الثقافي صدق يفتح عيونك وبعد يفتح مش العيون بس البصيرة؟ أحس أنت كإنسان نظرتك تختلف وبعد النهاب بينضاف لخبرتك, فبتبدأ أنك يوم تقابل أي مشكلة أو أي شيء في حياتك تشوفه تتعامل معاه بصورة ثانية.
We haven't found a nice sonically comfortable marriage between a genre of music and Arabic. And just lately, I've fallen in love with this new fusion of Afrobeat, dancehall, with Arabic dialect. And I think the secret to that is, funny enough, it's the drum patterns.
I'm from عجمان, not from Dubai. لأنه أبا الناس تعرف إنه ترى كثير artists مش بس راب, كثير منهم من عجمان. إذا بقول لك إنه والله بغير وهذا وشي, أنا كذاب, أنا إنسان أبا فلوس. بس لا, في نفس الوقت أبا أغير فكرة الناس عن الهيب هوب في المنطقة. بعدين أبا فلوس. عندك خاطر على الجيتار عاتب البحر كذا
دس الشاطئ, الموضوع بسيط بس شوية نار. لأبو ظبي كمدينة تحسها ملمومة يعني, فبسهولة إذا سويت مثلا عرض في جامعة على الانستغرام ولا تويتر, وبعد إن سوينا عروض في منارة السعديات واللوف, وعلى ما أظن من هناك إن صدق كل حد كان يعرف عنه.
I got to a point in my career where I turned into a machine, whereas I clock in, do the set, leave. I lost emotion for DJing because of what? Because of chasing the next big paycheck, the next big gig, this brand new venue opened in Dubai. You have to be the first person in there. I had a conversation with my wife and I said to her, would you mind if I just don't do this anymore? And she actually said, she's like, I've been waiting for you to say this. The next day I woke up and I quit the biggest residency in the biggest venue and my life changed. I heard something that Saud had made and I heard something that Kharsha had done. I remember I worked on it for about 2 hours, sent him a voice note on WhatsApp and he lost his mind. He sent me like 20 emojis, like pop, like just fire emojis. Like, how did you hear that? Like, how did you even get to that? So it was a fun process. And this is not normally what I do. I mean, normally what I do is very calm and chilled. So this was more like hype, club banger. Clean blood, dirty mind. Don't know this, let's rewind.